Today we're going to talk about the optical endstop and how to connect it to the RADDS board. In a moment, I'll show you how the optical endstop works and how to connect it. This is the front side to the optical endstop. When a field breaks it, such as the dental pick here, being a solid object, it means that the endstop has been reached. In a moment, I'll show you the underside of the optical endstop and how we connect to it. This is the optical endstop's bottom. Over here, for V, I've marked voltage as red. S is our signal pin over here. And then we have our ground pin, which is here. In order to connect it, we take our cable, which is notched, and match up the notching and slide it in. And then on the other side, I've traced out the actual colors. So we have red for voltage, black for ground, and then this one over here is our signal. In a moment, I'll show you how to connect it to the RADDS board. This is the RADDS board for 3D printing. I'm going to point out the pins for our end stops. We have our X min, our Y min, and our Z min. Then we have our X max, our Y max, and our Z max. Now, the pin over here for this row is 3.3 volts. Then the middle one will be our ground. And then the one on the end will be our signal pin. So in a moment, I'll show you how to connect the optical end stop. Okay, to connect it, what we have to remember is the outside pin is going to be voltage. The next pin over is our ground. So we're going to connect that like so. And then our very last pin is our signal. And this is all on Z max, so I can illustrate how it works in the Marlin firmware. In a moment, I'll show you how to connect the USB serial cable, and then we'll program the RADDS board. Okay, in order to program it, we need to connect our serial cable. So we're going to connect the small end to the programming port closest to the power for 12 volts on the Arduino Due board. And then the other end we're going to connect to the computer, and you're going to hear a beep. Now keep in mind, once it's energized, you don't want to touch this area. And in a moment, I'll show you how to program it in the Marlin firmware. Okay, we're going to open up the Marlin-Bugfix-2.0.x. This is an experimental firmware. So what I want to do is first show you around a little bit. Inside the Marlin folder, we have a source folder. We're going to go to core and open up boards.h. And as you can see, inside here is the name of the board for board_RADDS. That's what we're using. So we're going to copy that. Now we're going to close out of here. We're going to go back a directory, then another one, and open up marlin.ino. Okay, now that we're in the Marlin folder, there's only three tabs. There's configuration.h, configuration_advanced.h, but we're going to be working in configuration.h. So what we're going to do is we're going to find the motherboard. Okay, so the current name is board_ramps_14_EFB. What we're going to do is paste in the name for board_RADDS. That's what we're working with. And now to set up the end stop, because it's on Z max, we have to go find the end stop. Okay. For end stop settings, currently it is commented out. So we're going to uncomment that. And now it's enabled for us to use. So in order to load it, we have to make sure that the Arduino Due is selected for the programming port, which it is, and that we have the programming COM port selected, which we do. So what we're going to do is compile and upload. In a moment, I'll show you how to test it in the Pronterface software. Okay, now that we have the firmware loaded, we're going to open up Pronterface. We're going to connect to the printer board. Now that we're connected, we're going to type M119 to see the status of the end stops. Now we see that Zmax is actually open. So in a second, I'm going to show you how we're going to actuate it with a piece of paper. Okay, and now we're going to do another query to find out with M119 what the status is. And now it says triggered. So if we remove the paper, and type M119 again and press send, it says open. So if you like my video, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.